It was a lovely autumn morning in the garden. The sun shone brightly, and a gentle breeze stirred the golden brown leaves on the trees. But Bill and Ben were too busy to notice. They were trying to make the garden gnome laugh. But as he was made of concrete, they were finding it quite hard.
Morning, Phil. Morning, Ben.
Scamper had a big nut in her mouth, and they couldn't understand what she was saying.
Nice day for it. Sorry, caught stuff.
Flubber-lubber-weave.
Slow down, you two. I can't understand if you both talk at once.
Morning, Reed.
Stop! What is the big idea? Ben! What are you doing? What's so funny? I've just been attacked by these two hooligans, and all you can do is laugh.
Oh, Scamper, they were only trying to help. You see, they thought you'd got that nut stuck in your mouth.
What a ridiculous notion. I'm collecting nuts from the nut tree in next door's garden. I'm storing them up for winter.
Yes. Are these two annoying you, are they?
Not anymore, they're not. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important things to do.
I've got an idea. Why don't you two help Scamper to collect nuts for her winter store?
I don't know. Never think of anyone but themselves, these two. Well, that's youngsters for you, I suppose. No use to anyone.
Bill and Ben said that if Slowcoach was so keen for someone to help Scamper, maybe he should do it himself. In fact, said Bill, why didn't they have a nut-gathering contest? They'd soon see who was the most helpful around the garden.
Right, you're on. Yes. Slow and steady wins the race. Good for nothing.
Well, don't you think you two ought to get started? You've got a plan. Well, it had better be a good one.
Scamper, I've got you a nut.
A nut for me. Oh, thank you.
There'll be more where that came from. I'm having a race with those two nuisances. See who can collect the most nuts for you.
A race? But Slowcoach, they're much faster than you. They're sure to win.
Have they arrived with any nuts for you yet?
Well, no, but...
Right, I've got to fly.
Bill and Ben still hadn't started the great nut race. They were playing hide and seek.
Don't you think you ought to get started? Slowcoach has been nutting for ages now. He must have collected at least five. You've got a plan.
You, Tortoise, I've been watching you. Just what do you think you're doing?
I'm collecting nuts for Scamper. This is my fifth.
While Bill and Ben carried on playing, Slowcoach carried on collecting nuts.
Not started yet.
Useless pair.
Flubber-dub.
Bill and Ben needed a few things for their plan. They thought they'd find them in the tool shed.
Flubberdob.
Ooh.
The flowerpot men needed a plank of wood.
Flubberdob.
And an empty paint pot. All they needed now was a flower pot.
Scamper. Here I am again.
Oh, thank you, Slowcoach. You are a friend. I thought you said Bill and Ben were racing you to see who could gather most nuts. There's still no sign of them.
Oh, no. Too busy enjoying themselves, I expect. No sense of common decency, those two. Right. Better shoot off for more nuts.
I shan't need many more. You've collected 17, and my larder's nearly full.
Really? 17, eh? I'd like to see them beat that. Flubberdob!
Well, really? It's like a railway station in here today. All these comings and goings. What do you want?
Flubberdob nuts.
Nuts? Everybody seems to want nuts today. First that scamper, then that dreadful tortoise, and now you two.
Bill and Ben didn't pay much attention to the bossy Rose. They knew they hadn't got much time to lose. While Ben collected nuts and put them in the flower pot, Bill began to set up the clever part of the plan. It wasn't long before Ben had filled the flower pot with nuts. Bill told him to stand on the end of the seesaw. Bill was going to jump onto the other end of the seesaw and Ben would fly through the air with the nuts all the way to Scamper's tree. Ben was beginning to have second thoughts about their plan, but he didn't have time to think of another.
What on earth? What's happened?
A flower pot man just fell out of the sky.
Bill tried to explain about the plan and how it had all gone wrong.
I see so.
And a pot full of nuts.
There's no point in you two going to collect nuts. I filled up Scamper's larder, single-handed. It's like I said, slow and steady wins the race.
Bill and Ben congratulated Slowcoach and went back to tell Weed what had happened.
So you see, Bill, Ben, sometimes it's better not to play all day. Sometimes you have to work at things to... you're asleep.
And so they were, fast asleep and dreaming of another day.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Boo!
One day, the sun was so hot, it made Weed very sleepy. And it made Bill and Ben very lazy.
Weed.
Very hot out here. Oh, and what a lot of rubbish. It's a good job I do something useful with rubbish. It's a good job I turn rubbish into food for the plants. It's a good job it's a good job I do such a good job. Yes.
Oh, a rubber double up.
Rubber double snooze.
I say, you two. Yes, you, Bill and Ben. You can't lie around like that, you know. You're messing up the garden. It's messy enough as it is. And I can't do anything useful with you. I can turn grass and leaves into food for plants, but not you. You're in the way, making a mess. Don't just lie around. Find things, useful things, that can be used again and again. You should be useful like me.
Bill and Ben would never have a nice cool rest while Whoops was there.
Wait, I haven't finished.
So they went to see if Weed was awake.
Flubber, flubber, Weed.
Hello, Ben. Hello, Bill.
Flop-a-dop-a-dop.
No, I don't feel well. It's the sun. Oh, it's so hot, I feel all droopy.
Oh, flop-a-dop-a-goo.
If you could find something to stop the sun making me hot, I'd feel much better.
Flop-a-dop.
While Bill and Ben looked for something to keep the sun away from Weed, Scamper was still wondering how to use her shell.
I wonder. Yes, a hat. Oh, yes, very smart and so cool. It may be hot today, but this hat really keeps the sun off.
Flubber, what?
It's a hat. A sun hat. Get one for Weed. Get her a sun hat. Not my sun hat. Find Weed her own sun hat.
Boo had found a shady place to doze. But the shade had moved.
The shade? Oh, where's my shade? Oh, who's taken my shade? And what's this? Oh, someone stuck it on me. What is it?
I hope you're not going to throw that away, Boo.
What?
That's a piece of paper. It'll make the garden even messier. Do something useful with it.
All right, Whoops. What's a piece of paper?
And a rubber dubber dubber duck.
A sun hat? What a good idea. That might be a bit too... heavy.
Oh, rubber lob.
Bill, I'm not all right.
Flop it up.
Thank you. Oh, I'd like a sun hat, but I'd like one that won't squash me into the ground.
Flop it up and up.
Excuse me. I've got a piece of paper stuck to my spines.
Oh, flop it up?
Yeah, well, can you take it off me, please? You'll flub it up. Thanks very much.
Oh, rubber dubber dubble.
Yeah, I know that's a shadow.
A rubber dub?
Use it as a hat if you want to.
Oh, rubber dub.
Now, who took my shade?
I think it might fall off, you know.
Oh, no. Flub a dubber, flub a dubber hat.
Oh, don't be upset. You can use it to make me a sun hat.
Oh, you're the flop-a-dob.
I'll teach you.
Take one corner of the paper and fold it.
Bill and Ben tried to do what Weed was telling them, but they'd never folded paper into shapes before, and they found it rather hard. In the end, they made something that really looked quite like a hat.
Oh, phenomenal.
Thank you, Bill. Let's see if it fits.
Flubbered up.
Never mind, Ben. At least your hat will keep my roots cool.
Oh, you're flubbered up.
It's still very hot. I wish I had a parasol.
Rubber-dubber-sol?
I should love a parasol.
Phew! That's heavy.
I hope you're not leaving that thing in my garden.
I'm taking it to my nest for my collection of shiny things.
That's not much use, is it? Collecting things.
That's what magpies do. We collect things.
Do something useful with your things, like I do. If we don't do useful things with things, the world will be full of things that are no use.
Bill and Ben have been dashing round asking their friends what a parasol is.
My dear Bill, a parasol is something you hold up to stop the sun shining on your head. You could use, that piece of plastic.
Ooh! Flubba-dubba-sabba-lol.
Now, see, I likes the sun. Makes me fat and red and jolly and... Oh, they've gone.
Thank you for my parasol, Bill and Ben. Can you stay there till the sun goes down?
Flubba-dubba-sabba-down.
I'm sorry. Your arms must be tired. Have a rest. Oh, the heat. I feel all droopy again.
Oh, phew. Carrying forks is hard work. Whoopsie's not here, is he?
No.
He'd go on and on about doing something useful with my forks.
But you could do something useful with your forks. You could stick one end into my parasol and the other end into the fence. Then Bill and Ben won't have to hold it up all day.
Full up.
Rubble-up.
Ow! I'm sorry, Pry. We really need a fork for Ben too.
I'll fetch another one.
What a fine parasol! Thank you.
Oh, how clever of you to use bits of rubbish to make a parasol.
A flubble-up.
Ooh, a flubber-right.
No need to get wet, Ben. Shelter with me. Yes, Bill. Now my parasol has turned into an umbrella.
This is even more useful than I thought. Well done. I'm delighted you've all learned such a lot from me.
And sheltering beneath their homemade umbrella, Bill, Ben and their friends watched happily as the raindrops came pattering down.
Bill.
was a beautiful morning in the garden, and Whimsy was spinning a particularly lovely web. She was quite hungry and hoping to catch something for breakfast.
Almost finished.
Bill and Ben were playing hide and seek. Ben had found a good place to hide because Bill had been looking for him for ages.
Flop-a-lop! Flop-a-lop!
Oh, flop-a-lop! Flop-a-lop!
Now it was Bill's turn to hide, and Ben's turn to find him.
Flop.
Hey, flop-a-lop.
Flop, flu, flea, flaw. Flop-a-lop-a-ribba-lop-a-den. Lemon. Flop-a-ding.
Ben saw where Bill was hiding almost at once. He decided he was going to give him a bit of a surprise. Ben certainly did scare Bill, but not as much as he scared poor Whimsy, who thought something dreadful had happened.
Oh dear, what was that? Oh, maybe the sky's fallen in, or maybe the garden's exploded. Oh dear, oh dear.
Bill admitted that Ben had given him quite a shock. Now it was his turn to look.
A flop, flu, flea, flaw.
Ben, what are you up to?
Ben told her he was playing hide and seek and he didn't want Bill to know where he was.
Oh, I see. I get it. When are they going to learn that gnomes made of concrete?
Who's there? I might have guessed. I don't know what you've got to be so cheerful about. Flubber-under.
I don't think it was thunder. I think it was something else. Wasn't it, Slowcoach?
Yes, my tummy. I think it's trying to tell me I need my breakfast. I'm going to find something for my breakfast. I hope when I return, you two will have learned some manners. Not that there's much chance of that.
Oh, dear. I wonder if it's safe to leave. I'd better stay here.
I'd better find my breakfast soon before my tummy rumbles itself to bits.
By the time Slowcoach got back, it wasn't breakfast time at all.
Slobber up.
Yes, very well, thank you. Now, if you'll allow me to get on with my breakfast.
Breakfast? Oh, Slowcoach. Breakfast time was hours ago. It's nearer tea time now.
Tea time, did you say?
Oh, hello, Whoops. Yes, I did.
Oh dear. I don't suppose you've seen Whimsy at all, have you?
No, I'm afraid not. How about you?
Oh, well, I expect she's found something better to do. I'd invited her for tea, but she hasn't turned up. Probably having much more fun somewhere else. Unless... You don't think anything could have happened to her?
Well, I don't know.
Look, I shall have to go and look for her. I mean, anything might have happened. She may need my help. Could take quite a while, though. I'm not that fast. And then there's the birds, of course. What if they see me wiggling across the garden? My, my, they'll say. Look at that nice plump worm. Just the sort of worm I'd like for my supper. And they'd swoop down and they'd pounce and go. It's no fun being a worm, believe me.
Perhaps Bill and Ben could look for you.
What?
Oh, would you? I'll be ever so grateful. Sorry.
Sorry? I should think you are.
Flubbity.
Are you looking for Whimsy? Well, she's hardly likely to be in my shell, is she? Now be off, the pair of you, and leave me in peace. Oh, Ben said that it wasn't a spider, it was a spider's web. But Bill knew that where there were webs, there were spiders. Bill knew that spiders sometimes hide in their webs, waiting for an unsuspecting fly to land in them. When the fly moved the web, this would send a message through the web to the spider, who'd pop out to see what was going on. Bill hoped that Whimsy would pop out.
That sounds like Bill and Ben.
Bill and Ben decided that Whimsy wasn't in this web.
Help! Help! I'm in here! And I don't know how to
get there! Flubbadimby!
Flubbadimby!
Bill? Ben? Is that you? Oh, I'm in such a pickle! I don't know which is up and where's down and what's happening and it's all dark and... Help! Get me out!
Flubbadimby! Bill had an idea.
Oh, it was ever so brave of them. I don't know what I'd have done if it hadn't been for them. I'd probably still be there, stuck in that pipe. And some of the noises I heard.
Well, I think we should give Bill and Ben 3 rousing cheers. Here we go. Hip, hip!
Shh!
They're asleep. They've had a busy day.
Whoops! Whimsy and Weed cheered the 2 brave flower pot men, but Bill and Ben didn't hear a thing. They were both fast asleep.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
One afternoon, the man who worked in the garden was busy in the shed. He'd been working a long time. Bill and Ben and Reed wondered what he was doing. Then the man left the shed.
You can look in the shed, Ben, but be careful. Don't let the man find you. He may not be away for long.
Bill and Ben hoped they might find something to mend the broken statue among the treasures hidden in the old kennel. But first they met Pry, and she was in trouble too.
I'm stuck. I found this shiny plastic thing, but it's full of sticky stuff, and I can't get it off my beak. Can you help?
Oh, thank you.
Bill looked at Pry's sticky stuff and had an idea. He and Ben could use the sticky stuff to mend things. It might even mend the statue.
Oh, yes, take it. I never want to see it again.
Bill and Ben hurried back to the shed. But on the way, they met Scamper.
Oh, my poor nut. My best ever nut. I've been saving this special nut, saving it for a special day. But now the shell's broken in two. What shall I do? I don't want to eat the nut. Not today. Today's not a special day. Can you mend my special nut? Oh, that's brilliant. Thank you. When it really is a special day, I'll let you watch me eat my nut.
Now Bill and Ben were in even more of a hurry, but Slowcoach was in their way.
Oh, dearie me. Why all the hurry? I wish I could mend things. I wish I could mend the map of the garden. My map of the garden's so old, it's ripped in two. Still, if you're good at mending, why don't you mend my map of the garden?
Of course you're in a hurry. Everybody's in a hurry these days.
No time to help old friends. No time to mend precious maps. Oh, thank you. I knew you'd see it my way. Now stick the two pieces together with your tape. Oh, you have done. Where are you rushing to?
Dead.
I'll show you the way to the shed. Now, let's look at the map. Oh, I need my glasses. Where are they?
At last, Bill got back to the shed. But where was Ben?
Oh, yes, I've seen Ben. I saw him here. Yes, I saw him here last Thursday. The next day I saw him over there. Today I saw him over there. He was talking to Ted.
It's that rose next door. Keeps going on. What a fuss.
Doors?
She's only lost a leaf, but I've got to get it stuck back on, or I'll never hear the end of it. Any ideas? There's a reward. If you stick Rose's leaf back, she'll give you a reward.
Please be gentle. I'm very tender and terribly ticklish. Oh, dear me.
Oh, rub it up.
Finished? That was quick. Oh, you seem to have done a good job.
Flubbadabadabadad.
A reward? Oh, yes, you may have a reward. As you know, I have a glorious scent. Your reward is you may sniff it.
Fluffed up.
Most people would love to sniff my scent. In fact, I shall do so myself. Oh, glorious.
Bill and Ben didn't want the man to catch them, so they hurried to the shed by the back way.
What have you two got there?
I don't know. Flubbadubbadubbadub.
Sticky stuff, is it? For mending things. Oh, I might be able to help. Give one end of the sticky stuff to Ben. Both of you walk backwards. Ben, hold the sticky stuff with both hands. Now, try to shake it off. You can't, can you? You're stuck.
What you two will get up to next? I can see you're stuck. Stand still, then do just as I say. Bill, twist to your right.
Weed could see just how Bill and Ben had got stuck together. They did exactly as she told them until finally. Then Bill remembered they'd still got to mend the broken statue.
Mind you don't get stuck again.
Flubbing up. Flubba-dubba-dub.
Ben didn't know he'd landed on a tube of glue.
Flubba-dubba-dicky.
Oh, no.
Bill had an idea. Flubba-dubba-dub. They could use the glue to mend the statue. Bill and Ben had to hide the whole time the man was working in the shed. They had to hide for a very long time.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. What took you so long? Never mind. Tell me tomorrow.
Weed had been waiting a long time for Bill and Ben to come back, and she was tired too. She closed her eyes, and soon she was as deeply asleep as the two flowerpot men.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
Thank you. Early one morning, Bill and Ben woke up to find their garden looking a bit of a mess. One of the children living in the big house had had a birthday party the day before, and no one had done any clearing up yet. The garden was covered in litter. And so was little Weed.
Oh,
thank you. Oh, my. What a mess. Oh, I knew it wasn't you.
I don't know what the world's coming to. I found this lot in my house, if you please. Nothing to do with you two, was it?
No, Slowcoach. Bill and Ben didn't do it, but they're going to clear it up, aren't you? Yes, I know it's not much fun. But looking at all this rubbish isn't much fun either.
Why not look at the tool shed for a rubbish sack?
You could have some fun tidying up the garden. Why don't we have a competition? We'll get Scamper and Pry and Boo and everyone. And whoever collects the most rubbish will get a special rubbish collector's medal.
Soon the big clear-up competition had begun. Even Slowcoach wanted to help.
You pair of hooligans! I'll have to start all over again now.
There's a bit, and there's a bit. I'm sure to get the medal. There. With my super duper litter picker upper, the medal's as good as mine. Yes, and a good day to you too. What's going on today? It sounds as if everyone's gone mad.
Bill and Ben explained about the party and the great litter hunt.
I see. Sounds like fun.
Bill and Ben should have remembered what a mischievous plant thistle was.
I think I might be able to help you. If you want to make sure of winning, all you have to do is borrow everyone else's litter. Then you're bound to win, aren't you?
Bill and Ben thought this sounded a bit dishonest, but Thistle was feeling very mischievous indeed.
Oh, it's only a game, isn't it? A bit of fun. That should cause a bit of a fuss. I'm bound to win. I've had so much practice collecting nuts that I... Haunted hats! Help! Help!
The two naughty flowerpot men were very pleased with themselves.
There. A few more beakfuls and the prize is as good as mine. That's funny. I could have sworn I had more than...
No, not in there. I wonder where.
Next, Bill and Ben thought they'd borrow the litter that the garden gnome might have collected. Bill was going to distract his attention while Ben lifted the litter off his lap. Bill and Ben still hadn't learned that the garden gnome was made of concrete.
Well, I'd like to see anyone with as much litter as me. That rustling sound. More litter. Oh, I'll maybe come back for it later. There's no room for any more in my shell.
Hey,
what's happening? There's something not quite right here. And I think I know what. And the next thing I know, all my litter has gone.
Same thing happened to me. Well, without the hats.
Yes, and if I'm not mistaken, it's those two young scamps, Bill and Ben, who've taken it all.
I think we'll have to teach them a little lesson.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Help! It's a litter monster!
Litter monster? No, Scamper, it's me. Boo! I've been collecting litter on my prickles.
It's not funny. It might have been a litter monster.
Oh, I wasn't laughing at you, Scamper. It's just, I think I might have an idea.
Scamper, Slowcoach, Pry and Boo all found places to hide, and Weed pretended to be asleep while they waited for Bill and Ben to come back with their litter collection. When they arrived, they were going to have a big surprise. The flower pot men felt sure that they'd win the prize. They collected lots and lots and lots of litter.
Flower pot. Flower pot.
Bill and Ben, I am the litter monster. I know what you've been up to, and I am not pleased. You have tried to cheat in the great litter picking up competition. You must return the litter at once to the rightful owners.
Phil, Ben, stop! It was all a trick. A little trick to pay you back for your naughty pranks.
Bill and Ben explained about Thistle and told Weed it had all been her plan.
Oh, that Thistle! Well, you'll still have to tidy the garden, but I think I know where you can dump your sacks when you've finished. I expect everyone will be in a right bad mood now. Those silly flower pot men will have... Yes, all right. I'm sorry.
Weed had made some special medals from colourful sweet wrappers and bits of ribbon. She decided that as everyone had worked so hard collecting the litter, they should all have one.
Well done, Bill. Jolly good, Ben. Even
Bill and Ben.